Hi, I'm Cindy from BeDanceWear.com, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to take that top that we made that was so easy to take a sports bra and add some piping to it. Now we're going to rhinestone it. You're going to be shocked and amazed how easy it is if you've never rhinestoned before. And if you have rhinestoned before, I'm sure you know how easy it is. So if you just watch this video and we'll show you how we did this pattern. Really easy. Enjoy, and I can't wait to see your projects that you make. So when you're rhinestoning the top, you want to think about where do you want it? Do you want it all over? Do you want it just on the white part? On this one, and you also want to determine the size. How many will fit across? Do you want a pattern? So what we're going to do on this one, I've already put a little bit of E6000 here. I'm going to use the bigger for the center. And then we're just going to go ahead and start with one. Start up at the top. And I'm just going to go ahead and do a row across, three, and then what I'm going to do is I'm going to switch to two. You'll want to slide that around, make sure that looks nice and even, that they're touching. Now I'm going to go to two, right in this little spot between the threes. So there's a little niche that'll just fit right in there. Now you can fill this in more if you like. You don't have to go by this pattern. Now I'm going to put that center one in. You want to just kind of eyeball it, make sure it's staying down the center, and then I'll put the one to the right and left of it. And just keep going like that. And then let's go do the two now. You want to make sure and have enough glue that it sticks on. And if E6000 dries too fast for you, try one of the other glues. I know some of the people that watch like other glues better. It gives them a chance to get it going, get their pattern set up before it dries. So there we go. If you just keep going like that down, it'll fill it in. If you decide you want the complete thing covered, you can do that also. It's so up to you and it's a personal decision. If you want, you can go three and then four and then three and four so that less white is showing, and it really gives you kind of a cluster, and then you just continue that going down. It'll fill it all the way in. And the way when I'm looking at it now, I really do like the idea of the three, the four, the three, and then the four. You don't have to stick to a pattern. If you set something down and think you like that better, switch it up. It's all about being creative and being yourself and making it yours, not copying what someone else has. So you can fill that in and cluster it all the way down. Now then on this top part here, we're going to take the smaller size and just scatter them. It'll give a lot of shine when the light hits it. And I'm going to scatter it with a zigzag because I feel like you don't need to use as many rhinestones then. Something you'll always need to remember though, if you put rhinestones on a part that has to stretch, this band does not have to stretch, but this neck part does. So if you put rhinestones on that and have them tight across, you could run into a problem. Now I'm gonna use the toothpick here to guide this one over just a smidge. That'll keep even, so if I use this side for the glue, that side to determine where to put it down. Any little tool that you can take, toothpick, piece of paper, and measure it. So we'll do that. And there. And I eyeball it to make sure it's the same distance from the top as it is from the bottom so that it stays consistent. And then you just continue that all the way around. If you'd like, you also can rhinestone down these straps. Now, whenever I get to a spot like this, where there is a big break, I always like to put a rhinestone or something there so it just looks a little different. So we can put a bigger one there. And then we'll continue that other pattern here so it'll cover up that spot or like distract from it at least. And then we could just finish this pattern with the bigger stones. And then you just continue, check that, like that. So that pattern would continue all the way down. So it's really that easy. Have fun with it, enjoy it, make it your own. And I can't wait to see pictures of what you've done.
Thank you for watching our video. And if you enjoyed it, make sure and click here to subscribe, because we're gonna have some amazing DIY videos coming out. And if you wanna get our free complete dance costume DIY guide, click right here or go to bedancewearer.com/DIY guide. And lastly, if you have any questions or ideas for future videos, please leave it in the comments below. Thanks again for watching our video. And remember, be original, be colorful, bedancewearer.com.